northeastern, former northeastern, the three counties of Garissa, Wajir, and Mandera. On my right is the governor of Garissa, His Excellency Ali Korone. And on my left is Honorable His Excellency Mahmoud of Wajir. Our governor, Ali Roba, I'm sure you must have seen his position on this matter in the media, but he's out of the country. Our senators and members of parliament are here, 18 members of parliament, plus the three women rep, plus the three senators, and the nominated members. And our press statement is on the 2019 census results, which were released. And this is a statement of the leadership, the people of Northern Kenya, who we represent, including even our MCS. And it goes this way. The release results are not for the actual enumeration that took place on the night of 24th and 25th, August 2019, and that ended on the 31st of August 2019. Instead, we are certain that the data used, especially for these counties, came from pre-census mapping, data collected earlier, which were data extrapolations and not the actual numbers. Hence, this data, which was released this week, is false and not fit for the purpose of census as provided for both in the Statistics Act and in the UN legal framework. Number two, we see substantial negative growth in the population of the counties of County of Mandera and other sub-counties, in the region, which contradicts the basic principle of population growth statistics and published regional fertility rates. Moreover, this is not reflective of the Kenya National Bureau of Statistics projection of an annual rate of 3.2% for the NEP counties in 2009 census. So in 2009, our projection growth rate was 3.3 between 2009 to 2019. That is what Kenya National Bureau of Statistics provided themselves. And if you use that 3.22% in the figure they have released, it's not adding up. So we are telling the Director General, your numbers are not adding up. And further, contradicts the Kenya Demographic and Health Survey 2014, which indicates an average birth rate of 6.5. And I want to make it very, very clear. In 2009, the counties of Northeastern were 2.39 million. In 2019 census, we were given 2.47 million. Meaning, in 10 years, those counties, the number has increased by only 80,000. Against a fertility rate of 6.5%. The birth rate for Northern Kenya counties between a childbearing woman of 18 years to 49 years is 7.3. And you can check those figures with the National Bureau of Statistics. The birth rate for a woman in Northeastern between the age of 18 and 49 is 7.3%, while the national average is 3.4. So that tells you the number should have been higher in Northeastern than in other regions in this country. And I'll give you an example. Yeah, I'll give you a good example. Western region. And I agree with the governor of Bungoma. Western region has a much birth rate of 17%. Then you need to explain how Bungoma or Western Kenya with the 17% birth rate is beaten by Central Kenya, which is being given 25%. Central Kenya is given 25%, the actual highest region with the birth rate in Kenya is Western Kenya, which is 17%. So the DG must explain to us how he has, that's why this is cook figures. How come he has given Kiambu 25%? And again, you know, when we were before the census, I'm sure you heard people saying that we're going to deal with the population figures in Northern Kenya. Wajir North, Tarbaj, and Wajir East have a negative population growth rate, of course, and Balambala, and Lagdera, and Mandera West, and Lafay have a negative population growth rate of minus 17, minus 49, minus 18, minus 36, respectively. Minus 65 for Balambala, respectively. Meaning, since 2009, Wajir North, Balambala, Lafay, Tarbaj, and Mandera West people have had, and Lagdera had no single birth. In fact, no single birth, and there was a high mortality and death rate in those counties. So we want the really figures to come out. I mean, the country must be concerned. In fact, the president must be concerned why people in that region, in those six constituencies, are not giving birth and they are dying. Then we must be given an absolute reason. So if I just continue, then and you look at the Kenya Bureau of Statistics, deliberately reduced the number of enumerated areas during the mapping process compared to 2009. And I want to give you my former constituency, which was called Dujis, now split to Balambala and Township. Balambala was given 56 enumerators for a constituency that has got close to 7,000 square kilometers, while a ward in Garissa Township was given 59 enumerators. How come Balambala was 90,000 plus in 2009 for it to reach a constituency, and today you have reduced it to 32,000? And all the constituencies that have deliberately been targeted, Balambala, Tarbaj, Lagdera, Lafay, and Mandera West, these are among the seven constituencies that Northeastern secured in the last delimitation of boundaries. So there's a specific, well-planned, organized, deliberate, choreographed by certain people in government to snatch certain regions, both their resources given to them by the constituency, by the constitution, and their representation also given to them by the constitution, and we will not take it lying down. We will defend our people, and we will make sure that what the constitution has given us, nobody, whether in power or not, can. So we want to ask the DG to open the servers. We want to see the raw data. The question of servers is back again. We don't want the guy to give us a booklet. We want to be given the raw data. The raw data from the mapping to the actual census that took place on the 24th to 31st of August. We see a systematic scheme by elements within government hell-bent on manipulating census figures to consolidate resources and further marginalized many parts of Kenya, and more specifically, Northern Kenya, despite the advent of devolution. For the first time, the new constitution gave us a devolved system of government. It removed resources from the central to the counties. Now, somebody wants to create a scenario where certain regions now want to marginalize us and take the resources given to us by the devolution in the constitution back to certain regions. And I want to say this very clearly. Census in the Statistics Act is a function of is a function of the Ministry of Treasury, Ministry of Planning, National Treasury and Planning. This Kenya National Bureau of Statistics is a department in the National Planning Department of the government. We want to ask, how did the Office of the President, and more so, how are chiefs, DCs, county commissioners, regional commissioners, how were they involved? That is not their function. And we will take that matter to court. We will ask the court to decide whether census, as per the act, is a function of the Department of Planning or is a Department of Interior. It is very clear from the voter register of some of the affected constituencies that the purported numbers do not make sense. If you look at the voter register of Tarbach, Balambala, Lafay, Mandera West, and Lagdera, if you look at those, their voter register, you will be shocked that it's like 80% of the people of Balambala are voters. Something again very curious in Balambala. It is 32,000, 21,000 are men, and about 9,000 are women. So we were asking ourselves, what is going on in that constituency? I mean, when you have too many men, so who do they marry? Are they marrying themselves? You know, these are serious statistics figures we have picked. Other glaring inaccuracies include the case of the cosmopolitan constituencies of Wajiri East, Garissa Township, Mandera East, with huge household populations of over 200,000, which have not been captured correctly. It beats common sense that such constituencies have less than 20,000 households. So what are we asking? Number one, we are asking the server to be opened, the raw data to be availed, the mapping statistics to be provided to the leadership and to the country. That, and I'm wondering why the Huduma number is not yet public. So again, Huduma number is being cooked. They waited for the census to be released so that they see what, because we know the difference. We are aware the difference between the Kenyans who took the Huduma number, which they claim to be 99%, and those who were enumerated as census, the difference is 10 million. So as we sit here, they are cooking the Huduma number to tally with the 47 million. And for the first time, I agree that I think historically all servers should be opened. All servers should now be opened. So what are we demanding? We are demanding the servers to be opened under Article 35, access to information. We will demand for it in court. The court 35 says any Kenyan can ask for raw data, so we are going to write to get the raw data, the mapping, and everything. Number two, for example, Balambala constituency has a court order on why their enumerators were reduced to 56 persons when other constituencies in Garissa County had over 200, including my own constituency, which had, I think, over 385. So why was Balambala given 56? And there's a court ruling to that, asking the DG to increase the numbers, which he never did it. All these other constituencies I have mentioned, members of parliament and the people have written to the Director General. So we want him under Article 35 to provide the information given to him, and if he doesn't do it, the court will compel him. Number two, the use of these results in planning and resource allocation must be reconsidered. Number three, that the raw data be made available to establish the source of the result figures. Number four, marginalized parts of Kenya have realized that the fruits of their independence only was achieved after the enactment of the new constitution in 2010. This reality is now in danger, courtesy of this fabricated census. So what is now under threat is devolution. For many years, we were controlled from the center, and we voted for the constitution, the referendum of 2010, so that the center must not hold Kenya. Kenya's resources must be shared at the periphery. But now what has happened, bureaucrats in government have decided through the back door to rearrange the money that is allocated to counties. They cannot believe Turkana, Garissa, Wajir, Mandera can get more resources than some other counties. The entire data processing in terms of quality assurance be audited and made public. And finally, we are heading to court as early as next week. We have a team that is analyzing, of statisticians who are analyzing the data for us. We have assembled a team of lawyers, and we will challenge these results in the court of law. And we ask our people in Northeastern Province, they keep on producing, they keep on giving birth. We marry four wives. And you can hide the tyranny of number through fabricated figures. But I can tell you, in the next 10 years, through the streets of Nairobi, and streets of Garissa, and Wajir, and Mandera, and Kisumu, and Eldoret, you will see you cannot stop the tyranny of numbers. You can play with the numbers, but you cannot stop physical human beings walking in your streets, and you'll be forced to count them. So we are competing with you in tyranny of numbers. And the game of the tyranny of numbers is not played in offices, in the boardrooms. It's played in the bedroom. Yeah, so don't think you can cook things in your offices. Play you the game. If you want to sustain the tyranny, particularly the five big tribes, if you want to sustain your tyranny, you must retreat to the bedroom. You cannot retreat to the boardroom. You cannot use your office influence. And we will ask the court to do an interpretation. The first thing, under law, under the act, and we have pictures, and we have got a situation where chiefs have been arrested. We want to ask the court, between the Ministry of Interior and the Ministry of Planning, who has the mandate in law to conduct. This was not the case in 2009. I was a member of parliament. And that's why you see some people are insulting the former minister for planning, the right honorable governor of Kakamega, and the former prime minister. Because Oparanya knew the law, he made sure the census were under his docket. We want to ask Ukuri Atani, are you the one who was in charge of the census? Or there are other people who are in charge of the census? That is the question. He will appear before court. Who was in charge of the census of 2019? Thank you very much. I'll give chance to our two governors to add their voice. No.
Okay.
Okay. Ah. The gadgets are...
Ladies and gentlemen, let me join.